when Bear was 2 years old, my husband and I were hanging out in the living room with him one evening, and he just suddenly fainted, fell over onto the floor. So we called our local veterinarian. They had decided that he had a third-degree AV node block and that he really needed to go to OSU Vet Med right away. It was really scary at first because Dr. Brown actually said to us, he's not going to survive the weekend if you don't get him there. When we got here, we were actually met at the door by Dr. Scollin, and she took us right in and, comforted us, told us that, you know, it sounds awful when you hear this, but, you know, we actually can do pacemakers in dogs now. Bear has had his pacemaker now for almost 9 years, and he's doing beautifully. I just know that how everybody came together to save his life is a true, true blessing for us. We got to keep our dog.
We don't really have a typical owner. I think the one thing that they all really share is that they really love their pets and they are a big part of their family. And so that just, you know, for us kind of just affects the way that we treat them and that we know that it's part of their family and that those pets are really important to them and that makes them really important to us when we're treating them.
I think that clients need most from us to help them to really feel the genuine care that we all in this profession have for first their pets and secondly for them. And that's really what it's all about.
My goal is for my students to be the best diagnosticians possible. They will routinely be seeing patients over and over, and we come to the point where we have to take them away from approaching the world as a multiple choice exam, where there is an answer, to learning how to look at the evidence in front of them and come up with a broad category of what that could be and then coming up with what the next step would be. I think they leave here with a knowledge of what they need to know to be good first day practitioners.
I can't say enough good things about all of the faculty and support staff that I work with. That's one of the reasons that I think we have generally really good outcomes for a lot of our patients that oftentimes would be considered maybe more complicated issues, and I think that we can get some of these positive outcomes for our patients with an improvement in their quality of life because of the fact that I've got such excellent coworkers to work with, bounce ideas around, brainstorm, and come up with multidisciplinary approaches to treatment of these complicated problems.